considerable experience of butlering, sir. Now of a certain age and happy to take on the post of under-butler.
Name?
Stevens, sir.
Stevens?
Yes, sir.
That's your name?
This is my father, sir.
Really? Well, couldn't do better, I'm sure. Well, I'd like to see him sometime.
He's outside the door, sir.
Good. We'll bring him in.
Thank you, my lord.
Mr. Stevens, how do you do?
My lord.
Very good man here, your son. He does the house great service. I don't know what we'd do without him. Proud of him, are you?
Very proud, my lord.
Quite right, too. Yes. Well, very glad to have you with us.
Thank you, my lord.
Oh, Stevens, what are we at dinner tonight? 14? 16?
12, sir.
Right.
Thank you. Thank you, my lord. A great butler must be possessed of a dignity
in keeping with his position. There was this English butler in India.
He'd be ashamed to be seen as an ally of the French. I mean to say, it's not the English way of carrying on.
No, it is not. And it is precisely the purpose of our conference to discuss these matters informally, far away from the to-do of a large international conference, here in the friendly and relaxed atmosphere of one's home. Now, I think Mr. Lewis's fortune comes from cosmetics, actually.
Get a cushion quickly. Blanket.
Here you are.
Yeah. Oh, dear.
Oh,
my lord. Sorry.
Ring. I might have known you'd be up and ready for the day.
Oh, but not for 2 hours.
That's not much sleep.
It's all the sleep I need.
Yes. I've come to talk to you about something.
We'll talk then. I've got all morning.
I'll come straight to the point.
Do. And be done with it. Some of us have got work to be getting on with.
Yes. There's to be a very important international conference in this house next week. People of great stature will be his lordship's guests. We must all put our best foot forward. Because of father's recent accident, it has been suggested that you no longer wait at table.
I've waited at table every day for the last 54 years.
It has also been decided that you should no longer carry heavy trays. Now, here's a revised list of your duties.
Well, I fell because of those paving stones. They're crooked. Why don't you get them put right before someone else does the same thing?
Read the revised list of your duty. Now, you have what we can call a roving commission. In other words, you can exercise your own judgment, but within certain limits, of course. Now, the mops and,
Are these my mops?
Right. Or brushes?
My brushes?
Yes.
Or my mops?
Right.
What do you want me to do with them?
Well, I think you know well enough what to do. Father, look for dust and dirt.
And if I find any dust or dirt, I'll give them a good go.
That's right. Yes. Now, what I suggest you start off with are the brasses on the doors. There's that door there, then the door that's open, and then there's this door here,